बहुत साउंड ग्रेट नहीं थे।
केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग, हाउ इज दिस इवन ट्रेंडिंग?
Hi mom, I'm going to my friend's house for lunch.
What happened? Why so worried?
Is this whole world made of plastic? Wherever I go, I see plastic.
Actually, yes. Let's discuss this with Shivam and Arijit, who are chemical engineers.
What do chemical engineers actually do? Today itself, I saw a trending video on chemical engineering and I skipped it.
Okay Ajay, no worries. Let me clear up your queries. The main job of chemical engineers is to design and troubleshoot processes for the production of chemicals, foods, fuels, paints, pharmaceuticals and biologicals, just to name a few.
Chemical engineering in paints? Sounds too odd.
Not only limited to this, they are often used in large-scale manufacturing plants to maximize productivity and product quality while minimizing the cost.
Oh wow, this sounds amazing.
Ajay here is having doubts about the importance of plastic in our daily lives. Would you guys like to explain it to him?
Plastic is one of the omnipresent things in our daily lives today. Right from the toy that the toddlers play with, to the pen we write with, the mobile phone we use, to the walking stick of an elderly man, plastic has found its place everywhere, from birth until death.
But how did this plastic come into existence?
Today it's impossible to imagine our lives without plastics. But do you think that was always the case? Actually, yes. The very first kind of artificial plastic was synthesized by Alexander Parkes in 1856, and he coined it Parkesian. In the following years, other kinds of plastics also came into existence, such as Bakelite, used in making switchboards, cellophane, used in the packaging industry, nylon, used to make synthetic fibers, and polyethylene terephthalate, commonly known to all of us as PET, extensively used to make bottles and containers used in our day-to-day lives. All these kinds of plastics paved the way towards the plastic revolution.
Let me explain the basic chemistry of it. You know, the most important process in the manufacturing of plastic is polymerization. Polymerization is a process in which small molecules called monomers are combined together under high temperature and pressure in a chemical reactor to form a bigger compound, which is called a polymer or resin. Resins are then converted into pellets or powder form to be served as a raw material in making of plastic products.
There must be like clay which can be shaped into something.
Actually, the pellets that we got are now fed in molding or extruding machine, where they are melted to liquid form and poured in a mold of desired shape.
But I'm curious, how much plastic is produced annually in this whole world to meet the demand? Because it is needed in almost every sector.
Annually, it is around 300 million tons of plastic.
Wow, that's a huge number. But what actually happens to all the plastic waste?
At the initial stage, the plastic reclaimer sorts the plastic waste, which is then washed and shredded before melting. Once the melting is over, this waste is extruded into granules, which are later on very helpful in creating new kinds of plastic commodities. Do you guys know, about 60% of all the plastic waste is recyclable through mechanical and chemical processes, which include heat compression and monomer recycling process, where usually the recycled granules are mixed with the newly produced granules in the ratio 1:10 to create new kinds of plastic products.
Also, plastic industries need to follow a set of health and safety measures to minimize the risk of possible accidents, which are caused due to the use of chemicals, manual handling, noise from machines, slips and trips, working at height, and use of cutting equipment. Thus, if we use plastic judiciously by following the 3 R's rule, that is reduce, reuse, and recycle, plastic will be a boon to mankind for its versatile nature.
Oh, now I get it. That's how plastic goes on in the circle of life.
Thanks to plastic for helping mankind fight this deadly virus in the form of fishes and other plastic equipments. And we are in deep regard towards the chemical engineers who are working hard to save the mankind from the deadly coronavirus. So stay home and stay safe.